fascinating new study has identified a nutrient I had never heard about before, but is found in five specific plant foods that could rival, albeit a controversial, dementia treatment, widely used to treat cognitive decline. The plant foods are pretty unexpected and often undermentioned, so let's have a look at the study, and then we'll discuss these five interesting plant foods. Researchers took data from the Health and Retirement Study from 6,280 subjects, and participants completed a food frequency questionnaire that asked how frequently they consumed 163 different foods and beverages over the past 12 months. From this, the research team calculated nutrient intake based on participants' responses for 101 nutrients. Individual nutrients were assessed regarding their relationship to dementia. The researchers then adjusted for age, race, sex, BMI, education level, smoking status, alcohol intake, and physical activity. And what they found was extremely exciting. The results suggest that several nutrients were connected with a reduced risk of dementia. And one standout was called isorhamnetin, which is a type of flavanol. Manganese, dietary fiber, and vitamin E were also the other nutrients they found that reduced the risk of dementia. But it's isorhamnetin that I want to focus on, as it's starting to gain attention in dementia research due to its multi-targeted neuroprotective effects. Now, amyloid plaques are hallmark features of Alzheimer's, and isorhamnetin has been shown in vitro and animal studies to block amyloid plaque accumulation and even promote its clearance. This in turn helps reduce neurotoxicity, which is key in slowing cognitive decline. Isorhamnetin is a flavanol found in fruits and vegetables, but it's also found in ginkgo biloba, which is often used in alternative health spaces for dementia treatment. Now, the five foods highest in isorhamnetin are onions, almonds, cherries, pears, and tomato sauce. This study found that those with the highest intake of isorhamnetin had a 38% lower rate of developing Alzheimer's compared to those with the lowest intake. But going back to that first study, the researchers found that high sugar intake was related to an increased risk of dementia. Now, it's important to note that the study has several limitations. Asking people to estimate how much they ate of certain foods over the last year does leave lots of room for bias, forgetfulness, and guessing, and researchers did not adjust for factors like genetics and environmental factors that play a role in dementia. Also, these kinds of studies show an association and not necessarily a direct causal relationship. But adding in more onions, almonds, cherries, pears, and tomato sauce, whilst also reducing our processed sugar intake, can surely be only a good thing. Next, we'll look at two other foods that improve blood flow to the brain, and we'll discuss why this is so important for brain health. To view that video, you can click the middle of the screen now.